Hello everyone, today is International Day for Monuments and Sites, also known as World Heritage Day. It's an international celebration held on 18th April each year around the globe with different type of activities including visits to heritage sites and monuments, conferences, webinars, news articles, blog writings and much more. Every year for this day, the International Council on Monuments and Sites, that is ICOMS, which is an advisory body to UNESCO World Heritage Committee, suggest a theme. The themes for last 3 years were Cultural Heritage and Sustainable Tourism in 2017, Heritage for Generations in 2018, Rural Landscapes in 2019. The theme for this year is Shared Cultures, Shared Heritage, Shared Responsibility. This theme reflects the global context of heritage as a part of cultural identity at a time of rapid population shift, conflict and environmental uncertainty. This theme is also important as an expression of our global unity in the face of ongoing worldwide health crisis. ICOMOS has suggested that the celebration of this year's International Day for Monuments and Sites in the compliance with the instructions of local and national authorities so to ensure the safety of its participants. The story of establishment of this day as the International Day for Monuments and Sites or World Heritage Day is quite fascinating and worth knowing. It will also help us to understand why we need to conserve and protect the natural and man-made sites at present and near future. But before that, we would like you to subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon. Also, don't forget to share the video and like the video. So let's start.
All this started when the Egyptian government resolved to construct a new Aswan High Dam in 1954. The authorities realized that the reservoir will flood a large part of Nile Valley that contained several cultural treasures of ancient Nubia and ancient Egypt. 5 years later, the Sudanese and Egyptian governments asked the help of UNESCO to give them assistance in rescuing and protecting the sites and monuments that would be affected by dam construction. The following year, UNESCO Director General started an international campaign to save the monuments of Nubia. It was an appeal to the member states of UNESCO. The project took 20 years to finish, but it was a complete success. The Egypt expressed its gratitude to all the countries that made a contribution to the project. Following this, the Egyptian government donated 4 temples. The Temple of Dendur at Metropolitan Museum Art, New York. The Temple of Thebaud at Parque del Oeste, Madrid. The Temple of Thuf at Raschke Museum, Netherlands. The Temple of Alesia at Museo Agio, Turin. The project spent $80 million with 50 countries donating half of the project's budget. It also led the protection campaigns of Indonesia's Borobudur temple compounds, Pakistan's Mohenjo-daro ruins, as well as Lagoon in Italy. Moreover, it started the worldwide campaign to protect humankind's cultural heritage via a convention launched by International Council on Monuments and Sites and UNESCO. The establishment of International Day for Monuments and Sites. The special day for monuments and sites was established in 1982 by ICOMOS, and from then it became the day to promote cultural heritage. A proposal was submitted on April 18 in 1982. UNESCO's General Assembly approved the proposal in 1983. It is used to raise awareness about world's cultural diversity, their relevance and vulnerability, and the requirements for their preservation. At present, ICOMS has over 10,000 members, over 150 countries, making it the largest global organization of its kind, which includes professional workings in all the disciplines associated with cultural heritage places. Each year, a theme is presented. Last year's theme, Rural Landscapes, was connected to scientific symposium on rural heritage that ICOM was hosted in Marrakech, Morocco last October. The symposium was a means to raise awareness regarding the connection of rural landscapes, the challenges facing their conservation, and the benefits to gain from their conservation. They also discussed their relationship with sustainable development. This year's theme, Shared Cultures, Shared Heritage, Shared Responsibility theme, is also the overarching theme of ICOM's 20th General Assembly and Scientific Symposium that will take place in Sydney, Australia from 10th October 2020. World Heritage in India. In 1983, three important sites from India were included in World Heritage List, that is Agra Fort, Ajanta Caves and Taj Mahal. Till date, 38 sites from India are in the World Heritage List, which includes 30 cultural sites, 7 natural sites and 1 is in the mixed category. Approximately 42 sites are on the tentative list of UNESCO World Heritage Sites from India. Some World Heritage Sites from India include Khajuraho Group of Monuments in Madhya Pradesh, Qutub Minar and its monuments in Delhi, Sun Temple of Konark in Odisha, the Jantar Mantar in Jaipur, Historic City of Ahmedabad, Group of Monuments at Hampi in Karnataka, Kaziranga National Park in Assam.
This year's themes, Shared Cultures, Shared Heritage, Shared Responsibility, is with an aim to raise awareness about the protection and conservation of heritage sites. Keeping in mind the current scenario, the ICOMOS has suggested the celebration of this year's International Day remotely. Possible activities include getting involved in virtual conferences and roundtables, attending webinars and online lectures, making your own PowerPoint presentations, or sharing your own social media campaign for a heritage site in your locality. You can also post photos, information on shared cultures and shared heritage from your country, city, or area. Make short videos which include facts. Post your own photos from your last visit to an heritage monument. Don't forget to comment about your favorite World Heritage Monument in the comment section. I hope you liked the video. We will see you next time. Till then, enjoy the World Heritage Day.